Oh, hi! I didn't see you there. I'm Zach, and this is Calypso. You. Yeah.
Is alive and risen. Can we do that again? Sorry, guys.
I love the process of filmmaking. Every part of it. I love the teamwork. I love how it forces people out of their comfort zones. I love how it's taking, you know, skills that we've been nurturing for so many years coming to this college and even before then, and lets us, you know, run with them and do what we want and make mistakes. Make really bad mistakes, make really, you know, funny mistakes.
Calypso! Let's
see this again, why don't we?
And keep going, no matter what, because we had to finish this film.
Calypso's Island took us 8 days to finish, which was about a total of 30 hours. Which is not very much when you think about it.
How do you feel?
Pretty good, that's smart. Ethan, Burke, Ty, and I went out one day to get some blocking footage to make sure that we could capture the essence of Calypso appearing and disappearing and reappearing in different places.
We didn't have the means to make Calypso look like a ghost all the time. So we took this approach with it where Calypso is a live actor, and we had so much fun like trying to figure out other ways to make her a hallucination. And her character really came alive when we pan up and we see her on this weird dystopian piece of machinery, and she's there, and then you pan back down and all of a sudden she's coming in from over there. And so it was so fun, like, learning how to get that creative and how to make it work, you know, how to tell a story that was otherworldly and magical and mystical and dystopian, but with, you know, with what we had.
Little Pastor Amos.
At the waterfall scene, Ty completely submerged himself in the water.
It was cold. Socks are officially wet, that's all I'm saying. You know what I mean?
Thank you, Ty, for that. Each person had their own role, and with that, they had their own responsibilities that they rose to. Working as a team was something that was really impactful and important because we were each able to bring something to the table and then just have fun with it.
She's doing the call.
We had the people, we had the manpower, but at the same time, like, it felt very pleasantly ragtag.
He's helping. Oh, is it quiet on set?
And everyone had to struggle and had to put in the work and had to put in extra work. And that teamwork that all came together of us doing what we had to do, I feel like made the movie what it is.
One thing that's been really cool with looking through all the behind the scenes stuff is we get to see what the set looked like versus what the finished product looks like. And whenever you see that, it makes me so excited to see how cinematic and final our finished product is compared to where we started.
So Paige and I and Ethan, we would be in the conference room and we would use our phones and we would say like, okay, we need this one shot where like a flower comes down and we need it to be a tight shot of Odysseus, but then we need like a pan, like a rack focus from his face to the flower to show Calypso, you know, just like kind of reaching out like, hey, I'm here.
Working with the crew on this has been absolutely fantastic. We've pretty much and are starting to become a family.
Hey!
We just have fun with each other. I think it helps that we started out as friends already, and so it was kind of like, you know, we all got to get together and do something that we liked during the day.
Dawn, what happened?
She just chucked the stick.
It's the truth.
And I owe it all to...
No. Try to walk in.
You want me to man walk up to you guys?
Hi, how are you?
You know, this is the first one we've made in the practicum that's finished.
Great job.
In practicum history. And so now we know that, you know, next time we're going to get even better. And the time after that, hopefully we'll improve from there.
And then I learned the truth.
I like that.
What are you doing?
Say it, Paige.